With aluminum from some wheels I broke down in a campfire. Campfire. I'm running out of this stuff. You see that? Yeah, that's all I got left. My flux ready for when I need it. Really low to start with. Turn on the gas. Just got to burn for a couple minutes to heat up the furnace, otherwise the oil won't burn. Oh, it's my oil tank. It's some kind of, it's meant to go on a refrigerated cuff or some kind of, I don't know, physiotherapy or something, but it works pretty good. It's big enough top, you can open it up to let the oil cover the bottom, which feels nicely on this end of a hose I used.
It doesn't fit.
Turning it up at the level. Alright, so the furnace is preheating. I thought I was recording, lighting it, but I might have missed it. I don't know. I went back and my phone was off, so it's running now, but just on propane. It's preheating until I can start the oil drip. Well, these earlier parts, turns out my card was full, so let's go have a look. I got oil now. More oil, a little more air, pull those flames back down inside the furnace. Okay, blower's maxed out now. So the furnace is running pretty much full tilt. Hopefully this camera won't stop on me all of a sudden again. Some big peaks in the middle that are still solid, but the rest is starting to get contoured, crumbly. It won't be long now. Preheating some more stuff. As it melts, it'll be pour over the top of the bowl. Yeah, it seemed like I had some clogging my oil line. I opened the valve up, let it through, whatever it was, a little chunk of French fry or something. I know you're laughing, I'm using barbecue tongs, but they work. The strap is all now. I'll be able to push it down and help it get submerged in the molten metal. So it works. It's going well. It's still sitting on top of stuff that's not molten, so I don't expect it to explode on me. I
I left that rod in there because it's starting to get a little bit of stuck at the end. I wanted it to stay hot, so I can. I use it to test the point temperature. Let's see. Alright, we're full. Trying to let the last little bit of it melt.
Hey, the camera's still running, always a good sign.
When you see me poke at it like that, is I'm trying to push the little bit underneath the molten metal so that they don't oxidize being in the air when they begin to melt. Then they'll just burn up. It's now mostly molten, but there's still some semi-solid lumps in there. So all I gotta do now is wait for it to finish melting, and it'll be time to pull the crucible, flash, skim, and pour. So we're just about there. Just about. If I dip it in while it's hot and it comes out clean, I know it's ready to pour. So I'm going to do that test right now.
Alright, I had to move the camera so you guys. Well, you saw me mess up big time. Better fix my hose, I guess. I don't want to do that on me. Luckily, it's just vegetable oil this time. So this needs a diesel mess otherwise. Last melt was half and half. Alright, we'll see you at the shakeout. Okay, here we go. Try and actually get it in frame this time. As you can see, I did burn my flask just a little. All I have to say about this is, doggone. Edge of this guy's leg here that it stopped. Obviously this gate was not sufficient to let it fill. And I was going by these little gate marks, but I wonder if they might have machined a little more off the back of some of these and actually had more contact with the pattern. Of course, this is iron too, which is a whole different story than aluminum anyway. That's for this. That's not doing any good. The lighting is not great. And that's, to me that looks good. You know, you can see these little circular dimples in here from the pattern, this texture here. Pretty much everything came out. Yeah. The flowers and everything. Just didn't quite fill. I was never sure it would. This is awfully thin. I wonder, a little hotter. Maybe a little extension on the sprue. Here's where that bit of sand in the mold broke. It didn't seem to have harmed anything. Yeah. Well. All in all, that's a fail, I guess, but it's I count it much better than this, even though this guy is missing and most of the fence here. You know, this one has a better finish on it. There's no broken sand that wasn't already broken on the casting I used as a pattern. I guess that little bit there is really the only one. But anyway, it was fun. If I try again, I just didn't have enough contact with this guy. Otherwise, I think I could, I would definitely have wanted to hang this up on my wall. The missing parts were there and looked as good as the rest. I kind of want to hang this one up on my wall, see if I don't electrocute myself. But I got kids, and even if it's not dangerous to use a metal cover, which I haven't really looked into, you know, this hole's too big. Alright, until next time.